Hey y'all, Sarah Lehu here, and today we are going to be continuing on with our Kingdom Hearts series with the next game, Kingdom Hearts Rechain of Memories. Now, this is a in-between game between Kingdom Hearts 1 and Kingdom Hearts 2, and if I recall correctly, it is supposed to be like a remaster of an old Game Boy game, and this is our next stopping point in the series. There is another one that goes in between the two. It's called Kingdom Hearts 358 Days or Two or something like that. But, yeah, that one you guys told me to just wait and play that after Kingdom Hearts 2, because I guess it might contain spoilers or something. So we are going to hold off on that one. And Kingdom Hearts Rechain of Memories. Let's do this. Standard mode. Vibration. Yeah, sure, why not? Okay, yep, let's do this. So, where we last left off, we had just defeated, you know, Ansem, closed the Kingdom Hearts, sealed Riku inside with all the darkness and Mickey and light, and, Kairi had been sent back to the island, everybody had been sent back to their own worlds, and no one can travel between worlds, but we are off on some weird grassy road with just Donald and Goofy and Pluto. But this opening might just recap everything, so what am I even bothering with? He looks so brave. Oh yeah, Pluto was the one that found us. What was Pluto doing for the game? Was he just sitting on the ship the whole time? I really love this song. You got Winnie the Pooh and all that. When you walk away, you don't hear me say, dreams, oh baby, don't go. Oh, sorry. It's catchy though, isn't it? It is a catchy song. Goofy with that save. Seriously, that's probably one of my favorite parts in the game. You did not understand me at all. Sorry, I'm ruining this. It's a very nice mood-setting moment. I'm just terribly singing through it. We really went through so much shit, though. Like, seriously, it was a very epic game. We sacrificed a lot, didn't we? A lot. I wonder what would have happened if they tried to jump the gap. I don't know, there's a lot of questions about that separation that I still have, but it's whatever. Yep. Oh yeah, he had a letter from Mickey. But yeah, this is where we left off. Let's go get us a Pluto! Quite the long... Oh, did we just... I guess we passed out mid-run. And whatever happened to Pluto? Is he just gone? We'll never know what's
along
on
the road ahead lies something you need.
Oh shit. Naruto figure.
However, in order to claim it, you must lose something that is dear to you.
I've already lost a lot of things dear to me, man. Not sure what else can be taken. Sudden cut, jeez. Oh, is that Mickey's castle? Nope, that is not Mickey's castle. That is... Wait, are we still at the... Oh, so we are still at the end of the world. We didn't get transported somewhere else. So I was right, we were kind of separated still. Because I was talking about this in the Colosseum episode. Stuff like maybe we were still separated in like a different universe or something like that. Because I don't think it would be the worlds. Because we're too cut off. But what is the castle doing at the end of the world? Knock, knock! Anybody home? What happened to all the grassy roads? Was that just a trick of the mind? Where's Pluto? There are so many questions! Why was there an angel in a cage? Where's the angel in the cage now?
Hey, you think it's okay to barge in?
That's what we do!
The king? King Mickey's here?
Maybe? Just tell me he'd be here, okay? Whatever you say, Grand Wizard.
Really? Cause now that you mention it, I was kinda thinking the same thing.
Do we feel it in our hearts?
Seriously? Me too. One look at this castle, and I just knew.
What the hell, Sora?
Our very best friends. They're here.
Puberty hit you like a rock 5 minutes ago.
Wait, hey, hold on. It can't be just a
that voice drop, man.
Oh no, Timothy. You don't mean that.
Yep, I had it too. Mm-hmm. I had the exact same feeling.
Okay, I guess Mickey's here. We all feel it so much.
No, no, something screwy. We gotta go take a look.
All right.
What? Where are you going?
That way, to the door. Are you scared?
Ugh, it's bothering me so much.
Hey, fellers, shouldn't we shut the door behind us before we go? Sora!
Oh! I don't think we're leaving, Goofy.
That's it. Who are you?
Heartless! Oh, yeah? I'll try some magic! Thunder! Come on! Thunder! Thunder!
It's a valiant effort, Donald. I don't think we have magic anymore, though.
Blizzard! Fire!
Power dampening room? It's the white gnoll finger.
I should think it's obvious.
It's the room, right?
The moment you set foot in this castle,
yeah,
you forgot every spell and every ability you ever knew.
What?
In this place, to find is to lose, and to lose is to find.
Oh.
That is the way in Castle Oblivion.
Okay.
Castle Oblivion?
And we get owned.
Here you will meet people that you have known in the past. And you will meet people you miss.
I miss? Riku! You mean Riku's here?
I guess we don't miss Kairi.
What you want is to find him.
Rose petals. I think part of our soul just got taken there. A lot of rose petals.
What'd you do?
I merely sampled your memories.
Ugh.
From them, I made this.
That feels like a violation, man.
To reunite with those you hold dear.
What's this? A card?
It is a promise for the reunion you seek. Hold the card to open the door, and beyond it a new world.
This feels like a big trap.
Proceed, Sora. To lose and claim anew, or to claim anew only to lose.
So you're saying I lose either way.
Come on, let's go.
Card obtained, Traverse Town. Let's go claim anew, I suppose. Select a world. Left stick card directional button. Select card. You currently have only one world card. Alright. Traverse Town. Just like before. The way we go, I guess. Huh. This can't be right. It's quicker than the gummy ship, at least. We're in Traverse Town. What you see isn't real. This town is an illusion created by your memories, ingrained in that card. My memories. You took my memories and stuck them on a card. Get out of my head, you freak! Forget about that, Sora. We lost Donald and Goofy. So we have! Donald? Goofy? Guys, where are you? What'd you do with them? that was perfect. What did you do with them? They are at the mercy of the cards now. Master the cards and their strength will be yours again. The law of this castle require that your friends be transformed into cards. You bastard! You transformed Donald into a card? If you value your friends, you won't fail to pick them up. He just went to me! David, pick him up. Cards you pick up are added to the top of your stack. Use them and your friends will come to your aid.
Donald!
Kick his ass, Donald! Well, that was something.
The cards you use vanish, but they will reappear to aid you time and again. Cards are the hearts of your friends. Everything in this castle is ruled by cards. Whether an enemy or a door confronts you, cards are the only way to proceed. But you mustn't forget your own strength.
Oha! What? I still got my dodge roll!
First, think for yourself. Move, then use the cards.
Rip! Yeah! Oh, great, so... Every time I swing, it's the card.
You know, now know how to use your strength, but it would be of no use if you lose sight of your opponent. I wonder if you can catch me.
Yes, I can look. Oh, R2 to lock on. It was R1 before, wasn't it?
Good. Every move you make causes a card to disappear. If you use up all your cards, you will be unable to act. But there is a solution. Keep using cards until you run out, and I will show you.
You're being weirdly helpful. I'm not sure if you're supposed to be a villain or just weird. I mean, the Dark Hood and all that could be villainy, but...
You have no more cards, and without them, no power. If you want that power back, you must focus. Bid the cards return to you, and they will.
Reloading cards. Quickly select reload card and hold X. Simple enough. Anything else to teach me?
The strength of your heart brought back the lost cards. Amazing! You can recall spent cards at any time. You only need to wish it.
As long as I wish, I can get the cards.
But each time you do, the cards will take longer to return. The cards are by no means unlimited. Use them wisely. Anticipate the flow of battle, and choose the most effective cards. You may use any card in your deck.
Alright.
The four card types you use in battle are grouped into too wide a category.
Oh my god, I had enough of fucking Yu-Gi-Oh! And that shit when I was in fourth grade. Leave me alone with it. No more cards.
Card types you use are grouped into two wide categories. The first category includes attack cards, magic cards, and item cards. The second category consists entirely of enemy cards. To use cards from a different category, touchpad.
You mean D-pad?
Do I select?
Oh, okay, now I see. It actually did mean touchpad. Alright. So I just have to click it.
Cards will empower you whether you are attacking or defending. But it is up to you to decide when to attack and when to defend. Do not forget that.
I can talk now about Donald and Goofy. Up there. You two alright? Where have you been? You know, in the cards.
You tell us. When you opened the door, we saw a strange light. And the rest is just blank.
Jiminy? Any ideas? Gee, that doesn't help. Try to remember what happened. I have to keep my journal up to date. Oh yeah, you got the journal.
Hey, Donald. Where'd I get the new clothes?
Whack. Me too, Goofy. Somebody's been messing with our clothes.
Could it be the cards again?
That is for you to ponder. Master the cards and make your way through the castle, but from here you walk alone.
Alone? We can't let Sora go alone.
Yeah, Sora can't do anything without our help.
Thanks a lot, Donald.
You sure you'll be okay?
Of course! I'll have you guys in card form, I think. You want me to go alone? Fine, I can take care of myself. I've been doing a lot of shit on my own for the past couple episodes.
Humph, the hero speaks boldly. Go then, the rest of the castle oblivion awaits. Walk the avenues of latent memory and you shall meet someone dear to you.
Possibly Riku, I'm not sure. He doesn't seem to be a very clear fellow. I've got a bad feeling about this. Relax, Jiminy. I'm ready for any tricks he's got up his sleeve. How hard can it be to figure out these cards? All I have to do is use the one in front of that door over there. Card obtained. Key of Beginnings. Now that is an interesting character, though, that hooded figure. Traverse Town! Welcome to the party.
You can perform the following actions in the field. Left stick, move! Right stick, look around. R3 button, face forward.
R3? We can swing our key away, we can jump, and we can roll. R3, maybe it's the thumbstick. Striking objects in the field with your key blade yields various results. Try to strike into that barrel. Okay, yeah, so R3 is the thing. Yeah, struck! I've got something. I got Blizzard. And a cinematic to go with it. Or another barrel. Crate, whatever.
Ugh. Marked objects can be lifted and thrown. Crouch and press the triangle button, just like before.
Touching a Heartless on the field starts a battle, but you can strike the Heartless first to gain the upper hand. Try throwing that shit.
Yeah. Whoops.
Can pick this up. Nope. Nope. Oh, that works too. Ha! You're here! I got Goofy for my trouble. Ouchies. Ew. I don't want that. Ugh. I have, friends. Goofy, let's see what you got. Hell yeah. Let him go. Tranquil darkness. To open doors in the field, press the triangle button in front of the door. To proceed to the next room, you need a map card. Map cards are used to synthesize new, unexplored rooms. First, select the map card you want to use. Is it Heartless or is it this thing? You need to- oh sorry, it's saying things. You need to pick a card that meets this criteria. Cards have to be marked at values from 0 to 9. 0 cards marked 0 are special cards which meet most criteria. Card without a marked value is a key card. Key cards only used at special doors. Okay, so it was this. Ah, tutorial levels, man. Swirling crystal in front of Sora is called a save point. Yeah, I know, I play the VR game. Stand near it and press the triangle to open the save menu. You don't say. Can I skip this? No, I can't. Let's go ahead and save. Checking system storage for save data. Go ahead and save. Save that data. Yep. Oh, there I go. Alright. Well, we saved. We also have a map up there in the right corner. Does that mean I can use this? This is a lot longer of a tutorial, I feel like, than the other one. Oh look, another door. Well, at least I can skip over him if I need to. What? You know what I have? Oh, wait. Just having key card is enough to open this door, so I need a 1-up. Yeah, okay. Alright. There's only the two of them, though, so that's good. Oh, no! There's much more than two! I was a fool! Yeah. Goofy! Hello. Goofy. Got it. Okay, let's see. Not why I want it. I'm getting a voicemail right now if you hear a buzzing, just so you know. Alright. Let's see, I got Alchemic Quickening? Or Waking? Whatever. Oh, I leveled up! So I can boost my hit points, my CP, which I guess is my card points, and I can learn a new skill, which is Slight. Sliding Dash. That'll be useful, probably. Hopefully. Slide toward distant targets for close range attack, activation, 3 attack cards of the same type. Alright, good. How did I get a card and I need it? Okay, that one's not gonna work for us. There's also another door up there. Didn't I get a- Nah. Okay, so I need to beat up something else. Okay, I think there was one down here. And I also got some mages! Rude. Oh, got a new card. Stagnant space? It's a 5, so may that work. Yes. Alright, that did it. Am I through with the tutorial yet? Are you getting an actual cinematic or... fighting alone isn't as easy as I thought. Donald, Goofy, ah! Don't pop out of nowhere like that! Hey, it's not our fault. We don't know what's going on. Oh, yuck! Ah, Pluto, do you have that letter? Pluto? Things keep getting stranger. What's Pluto doing here? There's nothing strange about that. We came to Traverse Town with Pluto, didn't we?
I mean, no, Pluto wasn't in the castle.
Did we?
But he did come to Traverse Town originally with them?
No, wait. According to my journal, it was before you met Sora that you came to the town with Pluto.
What? He's right! We were chasing after Pluto, and that's how we ended up in Castle Oblivion.
But we never found Pluto.
But aren't we in Traverse Town?
Well, it's not really Traverse Town. I think the card created this Traverse Town inside Castle Oblivion.
Ah, who cares about all that? It's too confusing!
I don't know where we are, but let's just keep moving forward, defeating Heartless. We'll get somewhere, eventually, because that's how we do things. We just fight our way into Leon?
You'd better be careful, or it's the Heartless that's going to defeat you.
Squalion! Leon, it's you! What are you doing in Castle Oblivion?
Well, it's Traverse Town, right?
Castle Oblivion? What are you talking about? This is Traverse Town.
And how do you know my name? Who are you?
Is it because it's memory?
I've never met the likes of you before, because the thing said we would meet, you know, old friends and people we miss and stuff like that.
But is it actually them? Because they were saying it was an illusion before, so... what is reality?
Hey, I've never met the likes of you before.
Quit playing, Leon. We all fought the Heartless together, you know that.
Look, I don't know what you're talking about. I don't even know your names.
You don't?
Sorry.
I can't believe it. How can you have forgotten about us?
I feel for you, but you've got the wrong guy. Happens all the time. Don't take it so personally, Sora.
Ha! Ha? Ha?
He totally just called us by name. You do know his name.
Now hold on. Why do I know your name?
Because you know what. Or does he? This is confusing.
You think Leon's just kidding around?
No.
If he is, it's not funny. Sora's really upset.
Who's kidding around, Goofy? You and Donald are the ones who...
he knows all our names.
Hey!
I don't get it. Something's wrong with my memory.
Apparently. Don't worry, apparently things are wrong with our memory too. Donald couldn't, you know, cast... fire? Blizzard? Whatever.
Hey, what's happening here?
I don't know, Leon. Maybe Aerith was onto something after all. Who's this? Yuffie, of course.
She said she sensed some uncanny kind of power and asked us to look into it. Well, this is as uncanny as it gets. Maybe you should take Sora to see Aerith.
Yuffie, you know my name.
Yep, looks like you know mine too.
She's just rolling with it. You know him?
Nope.
Yeah, nope.
Told a stranger, but I definitely know his name. Strange, yes, but convenient. We can skip the introductions.
I don't know, it seems like we've kind of been going through that, so...
How is it that you can accept the situation so easily? I don't get you.
Well, I'm gonna run ahead and fill Aerith in. Leon, you give him the grand tour. See you later.
And I guess you're just going to take Pluto with us. He's your dog now.
I guess it's no use pondering over it. Come on, follow me. But there are Heartless wandering around town. Better teach you how to protect yourself in battle.
Are you going to teach me how to defend?
See the numbers printed on your cards?
So he knows about the cards too!
See the numbers printed on those cards? They range from 0 to 9. Higher numbers mean stronger cards. If you and your enemy both play a card at the same time, the higher card wins. Go on, try it out.
But how do I know?
Oh.
So I went 6, right?
Hurrah!
What?
I'm confused. Why is it breaking? See how it works? Not really. It seems like my cards are breaking and your defense isn't. Playing a card higher than your opponent's and breaking through their defense is called card break. Playing a lower card results in your attack being deflected, unless I'm confused. Are my higher cards lower numbers? Okay, being deflected. Even powerful cards can be deflected if the enemy's card is higher. Whoever is on the losing side of a break is left wide open to attacks. Don't let that person be you. Cards with zero as their value are special. No matter what card the enemy plays, you can break it with a zero card. But if you play the zero card too soon, the enemy can break it with any card they play. In other words, it's the most powerful card if it comes last, and useless if it comes first. Try to make the most of it. Okay, I'm confused. Card values also affect the cost of assembling a deck. Keep that in mind.
I don't want to play card games.
Now it's time to teach you how to stock cards. That's the most exciting bit. You don't have to use battle cards one at a time. You can also assemble 3 cards and use them all at once. This is called stocking cards. Stocking cards and using them in threes is much stronger than using cards individually. Go on, give it a try. Stock any 3 cards in your deck. Okay, the sum of your 3 stocked cards becomes the value you play. 13. The value is usually high and hard to break, and the combo attack deals a lot of damage.
Or wait, is the card on my right my number?
I'm confused. Don't hold back. Show me what you can do.
Use the 3 stocked cards and use 1 to 3 stocked cards? If I press them at the... I'm confused. Okay, so I... L1 and R1 together, does it? Alright. So that's why they don't have... R1 is the lock-on anymore.
Combo attacks aren't the only benefit of stocking cards. Choose your cards carefully and you can unleash special abilities called slights. Slights come in all varieties and each has its own unique card combination. You should try it out once you've collected more cards and learned a slight or two. I just did it. But keep one thing in mind. Every time you use stock cards, you lose the first card you picked. You can't reload it.
Wait, what do you mean?
The last card won't return until the end of the battle. Ooh, so if I stock all my cards, then I am left with nothing. I can't wish them back. Relying only on slights will cause your cards to run out. That means trouble.
Apparently. So I might be staying away from the stocked cards. We'll see.
Think you've got the hang of it, Sora?
Well, I mean, I guess you can. It only takes away the first card, right?
Yeah, more or less. I'll pick up the rest when I fight some real battles. Here, I found this lying around. You take it. Remember what I told you and make good use of it.
Card obtained. Symbol! And we got the Key of Guidance. Is that for another door?
I guess so, because it looks like we just got forced out of there. That is a blank wall now.
Alright, I'm going to step away for a second, but real quick I wanted to talk about the hooded figure thing, because that guy is kind of confusing me a bit. Because he doesn't seem straight up villain, like, you know, the villains in the actual first game, you know? But I feel like he might be a bit sneakier with his motives. I don't know if he's actually a villain or not. That's the, you know, weird part of it. They're portraying him as like, oh, this is the bad and all that, but it's still kind of questionable because, like, he walked us through this whole, you know, the card game stuff. He, you know, told us our tutorial, he gave us everything, he didn't attack us right away. He sampled our memories, which was really creepy, but, you know, he didn't, you know, just go after us when we were basically defenseless, because he said we forgot all of our skills and all that when we entered the castle. So that was, like, our most vulnerable stage, and he didn't do anything with us. So I don't think he wants us destroyed or anything, but I feel like this might be one of those situations where they're after something a little deeper, like part of our soul or our heart or something like that. But then it becomes questionable because he totally just like went into our soul and grabbed some of our memories there. But he said he only sampled them. Could he have taken more? Or could he only do sampling? Oh no, it's weird, but I feel like it's a deal with the devil kind of situation, because he's like, you must, you know, lose something to gain something new, or maybe you'll gain something new and lose something anyway, or, you know, whatever he's saying with his fucking riddle talks, but it's definitely like a questionable situation. It's not, you know, just straight up evil, but I feel like there's like some chaotic, maybe neutral stuff going on here. I don't know. We'll see. I'm going to run and do something real quick, so 1 second. Alright, all good. So we have another door up here. Ha! I earned a trophy! Ace Striker! The Striker of Aces! I think I'm doing fine, just... Well, pass good stuff over there. I jinxed it! There is a Donald card! There's another one. What was it? I have a lasting dage. Oh, I leveled up again. When you know him. Can't learn a new sight just yet. I should probably boost my hit points. Increased by 15! Wait, what did I just walk into? What the hell? I just defeated stuff over here. Nope. We will let... Wrong thing. Well, he took care of most of them. Really? Ah, no wonder. Alright, tranquil darkness. And all good. 1 second again. Alright, sorry about that. This is different. I can edit my deck. I'm not sure if I need to do that just now. Hey, we defeat those things, so we're going through this door now, right? That's where we left off. Okay, I need something level 3 or higher? Well, that one's 5, so there you go. It all worked out. Bruh! If only I could glide. Goofy. Nope, not what I wanted. Dang it, every time. Sorry. Still trying to get the hang of it because I can't go up and down on the D-pad. I think they just killed Goofy. I can only go left and right, but I also need my thumb in order to move around. So, you know, fun times. What the hell? This stupid card break crap. Seriously, cards are not my game. It's kind of hard to track things while trying to dodge and all that at the same time. Like, how was things on the... Not what I was after, thank you. Grand! I can just... I guess that's what the damn... What is it? Bumpers are for. I'm just not used to it. Not what I wanted, Goofy. Take care of that. Use it! Okay, jeez. And I got a new card. And I leveled up. Alright, let's raise our hit points a little more and then I'm gonna do a card boost on the next one. Alright. So it looks like a door over there. I have a door over here too. This one has a crown over it though. So I need three or more, right? I'm gonna hold on to the zeros. No? Oh. Had to select that one. No, seriously, the new controls are like throwing me for a loop. It's not that different, but it's just enough to throw you off. Aerith! Aerith, have you forgotten me too? I don't know whether to say nice to meet you or good to see you again. I don't think I know you, but I still feel like you belong here. Yeah, exactly. Like we've never met, but it still doesn't feel weird knowing your name. But I'm telling you, we have met. We took on the Heartless together. We were a team. It feels like you're right, but I can't remember. Then I guess you won't remember what you told me. In Hollow Bastion, when I sealed the keyhole, we may never meet again, but we'll never forget each other. See, you do remember, you dink. He's right, Leon. I remember you saying that too. I guess I can't write it off as coincidence then. Maybe our memories are mingling. I don't have any memory of it, but I somehow still remember. I think your heart is doing the remembering for us. Yeah. Like, I think when he took the sample of Traverse Town, he took the sample from before we met everyone. So that means that they're all still in the town, they just don't know us, but then our memories of the present and stuff with all the stuff they've said are also mingling and mixing with it, so it's kind of throwing it all off, so they do know us, but they don't know us. Okay. Heart's doing the remembering for us. My heart. We don't know you, Sora, but your heart is full of memories of us together. Those memories must resonate in our hearts, too. Maybe that... maybe they tell us things we couldn't otherwise know. So you're saying that Sora's memories are affecting ours? His memories do seem to have a certain power. Maybe it's like that guy said then. This town is just an illusion, something my memories created. And there's someone special to you in this town. How did you- I get it. My memories are resonating with yours, telling you what happened. Yeah, a friend of mine is somewhere in this town. I mean, Castle Oblivion. Castle Oblivion? What's that? There aren't any castles here. That's not quite what I mean. You see, we are in a castle which has a world inside of it, which is in a card. It's kind of weird. You're still not sure what's going on yourself, right? Hell no! Right, we just got here after all. I want to take a better look around.
Then go have a walk around town. They're heartless, but that's no problem for you.
Haha, so you know I can fight!
Confidence. I can't say I know, but I feel like believing you. Let's leave it at that.
And we have the key to truth!
And an alert on my phone.
I'm not sure if I even need to fight these guys, because I already have a few cards stacked up. Let's just see. If I can get on through. Alright, I need a level 6. That's a level 5. That's a level 8!
Open sesame!
Haha! Oh! Freebie card! It was level 8 too! Wouldn't you know it?
I'm not playing with you guys now that I know I can just flee.
Alright. Looking for doorways. Alright, none down here. Oh wait, we have a map. Okay, so we have one over there. I think that's the only one. Let's see where you can lead us. Will you take that one? Oh, no. I need this. All right. Sid!
What's up, Sid?
Well, what do you know? It's Sora. Wait, what am I saying? I don't know you.
But you do look like Sora. What with the spiky hair and baggy pants.
It's okay, Sid. That's my name.
So, you've heard of me.
Well, I can't say I'm as surprised.
Anyway, maybe you can help me out. A friend of mine's supposed to be somewhere in this castle or town, something like that. Got any ideas?
How to get out of this card, for starters?
Your friend, huh? Lately all this town sees is heartless. Can't even take two steps without getting attacked.
Yeah, trust me, I know.
In fact, this plaza's the worst. Word is, a jumbo-sized heartless shows up right when the bell rings.
Oh, fun. Have I gotten to a boss battle already?
If you value your hide, you'll get out of here in a while the getting's good.
Gosh, maybe we should leave.
Don't you want to see the Heartless?
No, not particularly.
No, we don't.
Well, shit.
I guess we have a boss battle.
The bell.
Be careful, Sora.
Does this mean you guys don't have to be cards today? Because, I mean, they're already here. They don't have to be cards, right?
Nope, they have to be cards.
Because all that matters is cards.
Cards is love! Cards is life!
Uh-oh.
Right!
Don't want to use all the cards. But we do what we can, when we can. Uh-oh, where'd it all go?
Oh, at least I can still dodge.
Alright, Donald, go! Surely you can do something. Uh-oh, can't do that. Need... Alright, that's more like it. They're not good enough! Well, that was useless. Need that card! Alright, Goof. Your turn!
Alright, stack these. Let's try that. Well, that was useless. I have to be in range. Oh, not great, not great. Alright, I don't know what this does. Well, it did something great. No, it was great! I should probably focus on certain things, right? I'm running out of cards. That's my own fault, though, for stacking. Or stalking! Grab that. The most useful card of all! And what? Perfect. Alright, I want this. Use it! And then fart! That's the important one. Come on, come on. Nope. If it starts cannoning, then we have a problem. Donald! You take care of that for a bit. Ouchies. Use it! Yeah, there we go. All worked out. Can't say I'm great at this. Ugh. Kablooey? Well, at least I haven't died yet. How's that going for me? We got a boss card! Guard obtained. Guard armor. Does that mean I can use these? It says I obtained them, but I haven't really tried, you know, equipping my deck any. So, your friend wasn't here. No, I don't think you'll find him in this town. But he's somewhere in this castle, I just know it. Have to get out of this card first, though. Castle? Like, this whole town's inside some humongous castle? Huh, that's rich. More like it's in a card in a castle and a oblivion. He's probably right, Cid. We may not understand what's going on, but Sora does. He can see the reality is bigger than just this world. I wish I was that sure. You'll be okay, Sora. No matter what shape reality takes, you can handle it. I may not remember you, but I know you in my heart. Leon! He knows me in his heart! Take care, Sora! God, Cid, you're an itchy person. I'm a little lost, but best of luck anyway. Peace out, friends! Okay. Oh, Aerith? Cards? Do you have a card for me? What's up?
I don't have all the answers, but I had to tell you something. Your memories created this town, right?
That's what the guy who gave me the card said.
If that's true, then this town is just a figment of your mind, and so are we.
Ugh, that's an existential crisis. But you can't be a figment, you're standing right here! The town is here too!
But I'm not really me. I don't remember the things I should, and I sense things I shouldn't. Sora, beware your memories. In this journey to come, you'll be faced with more illusions. Sometimes the shadows of your memories will deceive you, try to lead you astray.
So, what exactly does that mean? Can my own memories be my worst enemy?
I'm sorry, I'm just an illusion. The truth is out of my reach.
Don't say stuff like that, it's depressing.
Stay strong, Sora. Don't let the illusions distract you from what's truly important.
Okay. Bye. Sora! Are you ready to go?
Yeah, be right there. Well, I'd better get going. Be going.
And she's gone!
Aerith? Just a figment of your imagination. Aerith!
What about Aerith?
Wait, where'd she go? I was just talking to her.
Aerith left with Leon and the others, remember?
Huh?
Tried to deceive you. You worried us, just standing there by yourself, talking to the wind and such.
Is this what she meant?
Donald Goofy, are you actually here?
I can't trust anybody anymore.
I thought I was going to zoom out onto a person watching us or something.
This is new, right? Is this new? I don't think I've been here. Seems like a tall ladder. Is this my way out? See you again. I should probably save, right? Save! Jakey. Alright, we are level 4. Good to know. So this is our exit? I'm sorry, I just want to get out of Traverse Town before we end the episode.
You! Rose Petal Ghost! What's the meaning of all this?
Well, things are kind of weird.
Did you enjoy meeting your memories?
We're all blurry. Why are we blurry?
Yeah, it was good to see everyone. But what do you really want from me?
What do you have to give?
I don't like that. Hello.
Hello.
Hi. You sound familiar.
No hog in the hero.
He looks like Reno.
Then perhaps you'd like to test him.
Perhaps I would.
Kind of sounds like him too.
My show now, Keyblade Master. Who am I? Oh, my name's Axel. Got it memorized?
Sure.
Yeah, I guess.
Good. You're a quick learner.
You're a smug asshole.
Now that we're getting to know each other better.
Holy shit! He has those things! Oh!
Don't you go off and die on me now.
I love those things! Oh, what was that character's name from Soul Calibur? Valdo! Oh! That was my weapon back in the day, man. Oh shit! He is actually fighting me. Whoa! Rude, sir! Where is he? Fuck. Okay, that'll keep it. Okay, damn. Can I get a hit in?
Come here. I'll make it all stop.
Yeah. You'll make it all what? I almost got him. Might as well take that. Oh dear. Goofy!
Come here. I'll make it all stop.
Oh, you make it all stop. That's what you're saying. Woo! You are not a very nice fellow. Okay, we got Donald. Ooh, Donald! Yeah, you do it. I can't charge well. This ain't great. Oh, I get it now.
Let the flames burn you.
I can't do it. I can use. Damn it. Need. Donald. Shit. Not a great day. There we go. Goofy. So he breaks me while that's going on. That's not very dodgeable. Oh, okay. I see a problem there. Okay, so I can't hit him while he's doing that burn thing. But I do stand a chance right here. You little pain in my butt. I'm good. Two and one. They really don't do that much damage. Ha!
Give me a break.
That was actually a really nice hit right there, just coming in from behind and striking them. You could see the pain on his face. Lovely. And we got whatever that is. Fire! Haha! We've learned a magic! Alright, I said I would do card boost this time. So I'm definitely running low on the cards.
Another one? What's it do?
I wonder if they're just kind of blurry because of the white room.
Kind of looks like the card you used when you made Traverse Town.
Then I guess we're gonna need it to keep going.
That's right.
You look smug for losing. Was he just testing us?
Did you really think after that introduction I would give up oh so easily?
You were testing us.
Yep.
And you passed. Congratulations, Sora. You're ready now. Ready to take on Castle Oblivion.
Tutorial's over.
You will need to follow your memories. Trust what you remember and seek what you forget. Then you will find someone very special.
You mean King Mickey and Riku?
You will just have to give some more thought to who it is that's most important to you.
Kyrie?
Our most precious memories lie so deep within our hearts that they're out of reach. But I'm sure that you can find yours, Sora.
Why me?
You have lost sight of the light within the darkness, and it seems that you've forgotten that you forgot.
The light within darkness?
This is complicated.
Would you like me to give you a hint?
The hand! So, offering the hand!
Do you need it?
I don't know! I don't feel like I can trust you!
I'm gonna figure it out for myself. If you're in my way...
Don't worry, Sora. We'll protect you!
Aww.
Good answer. Just what I'd expect from the Keyblade Master.
Another test? Goofy, shouldn't you be up front?
But be forewarned. When your sleeping memories awaken, you may no longer be who you are now.
Have I repressed memories? What have I forgotten? Oh, whoa, cards obtained. Oh my god, I got like everywhere. That was interesting. Okay, so kind of a boring start, but it really picked up there towards the end. All right, it's weird. I'll give it that. It is super weird, but that just makes it all the more interesting in my opinion. Because, you know, before we were kind of, you know, straight cut hero's journey, you know, going on with the first game. You know, we were nervous and split apart from our friends. We weren't really sure if we knew we're able up to the task. You know, we had our doubts there at the end of the game when Riku took the Keyblade from us and all that stuff. But, you know, it was just pretty forward, straightforward, you know, good versus evil and darkness and all that. And I don't know what to make of these guys. These weird
like, black-robed dudes. Because, like, there's clearly an agenda here. They're not just messing with us to, you know, benefit us. They're trying to benefit themselves, clearly, but, like, for what? What is it? We're going to find out as we get further into the game, but everything's, like, so weird and stuff. And all I'm thinking right now is, like, Alice in Wonderland, you know, curiouser and curiouser, because nobody's making sense, but everybody's, you know, speaking wonderful little riddles and stuff like that. You know, it's like, you know, you'll get something new if you lose something, or maybe you'll lose something for getting something new and all that, and then, you know, you've forgotten something, your memories are going to be trained to deceive you. You know, we're really just kind of playing against our own head here, and whoever these weirdos are that are kind of trying to distract us from it. But I don't know, I can't say that, you know, they're evil or not. Because you would expect that. You would expect, you know, straight up good versus evil with, like, a Disney game. But, you know, that's what I thought going into Kingdom Hearts 1. And we had, you know, some really complex characters in that, you know, with, like, Riku and his, you know, whole struggle. And Riku was on the bad guy's side in that, but he wasn't an evil character. And so I'm wondering if they're trying to expand on that more with these guys. Because they're not coming up straight across, you know, evil. But then again, we haven't seen their whole plan. We just know that they're trying to get us to do something with our own memories, to find something. And we have a hint that we've forgotten something. He says we've forgotten the light and the darkness, but I don't think that's true, because we still have hope. We still have hope that we're going to find Riku, but are they hinting at Kairi actually being the one most important to us? But we think Kairi's safe. What if she's not safe? Why would it fake out like that? Oh, there's so many questions, but it's so good so far. Ugh. Alright, so, yeah, the only thing that I'm really, really not digging is this weird combat. But I get it, it's like a remaster of an old, you know, Game Boy game. You can't expect it to, you know, be ideal for the PlayStation, but, you know, it's something. And I'm still getting used to, you know, combat situations, I guess, with the PlayStation controller, because with the Kingdom Hearts games, they're much more melee, and the only, like, action-y game that I've played on here would be the Uncharted games so far. Well, yeah, Uncharted and Last of Us, but those were more, you know, like, aim-and-shoot sorts of situations. I haven't really played very much melee stuff with PlayStation so far, I don't think. Pretty sure I haven't. It's just been Kingdom Hearts, and now they've gone and changed the rules and the controls on me, and so, you know, it's an adjustment. The only thing is, they don't really seem, either they're giving me, like, a lot of grace to learn the new controls, but nothing really seems to be doing that much damage. I'm wondering if that's going to be consistent, like, I'm going to be able to just go through this without dying, or, you know, what the situation is going to be. But, yeah, that's it for this episode. Next time we will continue further into the castle, explore new worlds, test out our memories, and see what we could see. So, until then, like and subscribe if you guys want to, and thank you for watching.